We continue with Tigers Roar. I'm Tommy Chrysant of Pelican Sports TV. On my left is Carter Bryant.
Great show so far, huh?
Roll into hour number two. Boy, we've had football. We've had with Lady Tiger basketball. We had Lillian Axe. We had Debbie Traylor, two music members of the Louisiana Music Hall of Fame. We've had all kind of good stuff for you. And we still got another hour to go with plenty of stuff. But right now, we're waiting to see if we have connected with Brian Lazar of TigerBait.com. As we try to join him, I'm waiting to see. Yeah, okay. Hey, Brian Lazar, TigerBait.com. How you doing this evening?
Good, Tommy. How you doing tonight?
Oh, we're hanging in there on a Wednesday. Appreciate your time tonight, as always. Start off with, Brian, LSU spring football. Everybody's been wanting to have something different to talk about since January 9th, and now they do. What is your early read on what's going on with spring football?
Well, again, you know, they've been out there four times. Yesterday was the first day that they're in pads, and, you know, of course, we see very little. We see the first 20 minutes of practice of doing individual drills. I'll say this, they are really, really stressing technique so far in spring. I'll just say, for example, the defensive backs, they're doing most of their drills without even using a football. A lot of work being done with the offensive line on technique, particularly with the number two offensive line, where you have all guys who have never played before. So a lot of work taking care of the little things and getting that down pat first. As regards, the quarterbacks, Zach Mettenberger, Steven Rivers, Gerard Randall. You know, there's no doubt Mettenberger has a strong arm. I think he's got to work on his accuracy, and probably going along with that, he has to work a little bit with his feet. I've done a couple of interviews with him where he has said he's going to have to always be very conscious of how he does with his feet, because being so big, that's going to be very important for him. So I thought the receivers as a group have looked well. They've caught the ball quite well. The young guys in the secondary, because that's, for me, that was a concern going into spring. Were they going to have to come up with some new players there with only three returnees out of their top six? And I would say that the newcomers, three redshirt freshmen, David Jenkins and Jalen Collins at the corners, and Micah Eugene at safety, along with Ronald Martin, who played a little bit last year. Those four guys are comprising the secondary, and right now in the drill, they look pretty good.
All right, Brian, let's shift gears. First to Lady Tiger basketball. Nikki Caldwell's team should be in the NCAA tournament when that's announced next Monday, and should be playing in Baton Rouge, first and second round, being hosted in the Pete Maverick Assembly Center.
Got to give her a lot of credit for what she did. First of all, congratulations for her baby being born yesterday morning. But you have to give her and the staff a lot of credit. You know, they're sitting there at 4-5 on a five-game losing streak on the conference, and they turned it around, won six straight games, and then after losing to Georgia in the regular season finale, won a couple games in the SEC tournament to get to the finals. So they've won 8 of their last 10 games, and just waiting to see what type of seed they get for the NCAA tournament. You know, they certainly will have a chance to win their first game, and then it'll be interesting to see who they matched up with if they win that and get in the second round.
We're visiting with Brian Lazar of TigerBait.com. Brian, Trent Johnson's men's basketball team stumbled down the stretch, as we know. Play Arkansas at 12 noon in New Orleans in the SEC tournament tomorrow. Any shot that this team can get in the NIT?
I'll say it like this. I believe there are three things that have to happen for them to have a chance to get into the NIT. Number one, they have to defeat Arkansas tomorrow. Number two, Ole Miss has to lose to Auburn, because I think right now Ole Miss is ahead of LSU in the pecking order of teams that are being chosen for tournaments from the SEC. And that's why I think LSU needs to win tomorrow and Ole Miss to lose for LSU to go past them in the pecking order. And then thirdly, I think that the SEC has to have five teams get picked for the NCAA tournament. LSU, as I said, the highest they can be in the SEC would be considered as the seventh team. if the NCAA tournament only chooses four SEC teams, I don't see the NIT taking three from the SEC. So those are the three things I think have to happen. LSU has to win, Ole Miss has to lose, and then on Sunday, five SEC teams have to get picked for the big dance.
Brian Lazard, a baseball team defeated Tulane 5-0 in New Orleans last night. An outstanding performance by freshman pitcher Aaron Nola. Competition's going to get a little tougher this weekend.
Well, I don't know about that because, you know, Michigan 6-6, Notre Dame 5-4. Neither team is projected to be an NCAA tournament team. I think, yeah, I mean, are those two teams better than Dartmouth? Yes, they're better than Dartmouth. Are these two teams near the competition that LSU is going to see in the SEC? No, not at all. I don't know if – I mean, I'm pretty sure neither Michigan nor Notre Dame would say finish in the top eight in the SEC. So I really don't think those two teams are necessarily any better than Tulane. I think that last night's victory was a big one. Aaron Nola, great job. He certainly seems – has shown that – he's someone they can count on when they get into the SEC. It'll be interesting to see how Paul Maneri uses Nola. I'm sure the best-case scenario, Maneri probably hopes that Kurt McCune begins to pitch well again so he can keep McCune in the Sunday start spot, and then he has Nola available to come out of the bullpen more than once on a weekend. But he now knows that if McCune falters, at least he has Nola that he can plug into the Sunday starting spot.
Brian Lazard, tell everybody what they're going to get when they go to TigerBait.com.
www.TigerBait.com, a 7-day free trial all the time. Right now, plenty coverage of spring football practice. We have practice reports every day. We have video of practice. We have video interviews of players. We have feature stories on players, and that will continue on through the end of practice, which is March the 31st. We'll be covering LSU in the SEC tournament tomorrow against Arkansas. And, of course, we'll have coverage of the baseball team when they take on Michigan and Notre Dame this weekend.
Brian Lazard, as always, we appreciate your time. Look forward to visiting with you again.
Thank you a lot, Tommy.
All right. As Brian Lazard of TigerBait.com does a really good job. Missed him last couple weeks. He's out working hard covering basketball while we were here. In fact, when we come back, we're going to talk about Trent Johnson's team. We're going to hear from Coach Johnson, as well as some of the players as they get ready for the SEC tournament right there in New Orleans at the New Orleans Arena. Carter Bryant, Tommy Chrysan, this is Tigers Roar on Pelican Sports TV, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and New Orleans, and on the internet at PelicanSportsTV.com.
This is Mo Isom of the LSU women's soccer team, and you're watching Pelican Sports TV.
I'm attorney Kerry Bryson. An IRS problem is a serious legal matter. The IRS has thousands of agents trained to understand it all. So don't trust an out-of-town salesperson. Come meet with us in person at our office right here in Baton Rouge. Your first visit will be free and confidential. If you're a Louisiana resident and have an IRS problem, hire a Louisiana attorney. Hire me, Kerry Bryson.
Hey, I'm Dr. Bob Benson. What's the difference between every other hair restoration method and NeoGraft? It's like comparing a musket to a sharpshooter's rifle. Old methods use a scalpel, which scars the back of the head, but with NeoGraft, there's no scarring because each tiny follicle is removed individually under local anesthesia. Walk in, walk out, natural hair restoration, no scarring. I waited 35 years for this technology, and then I became a patient. Call us today for your free consultation.
Hey, everyone's eating tacos outside Bill's office.
Don't you think that's some information I would like to know? I like tacos.
You invited Eric?
I thought Eric gave you the creeps.
Oh. Yeah. Hey.
Don't be left behind. AT&T, the nation's fastest mobile broadband network, is getting faster with 4G.
Now is a great time to lock into buying a new home. Come by our decorated model home in Greystone of Prairieville. We are starting the development of our second filing and offering builder's special closeout pricing on the remaining homes in our first filing. No money down and builders pay closing costs. For more information, visit our website at graystoneofprairieville.com. Come home to Greystone.
We continue with Tiger's Roar. Don't forget Pelican Sports Radio Monday through Friday from 3 to 4 p.m. on KKAY 1590 AM on your radio dial. There's a free app on the smartphone, tunein.com. It's also on the internet at KKAY1590.com. You can email us for more information or go find Pelican Broadcasting on Facebook. Great way to communicate and keep up with us. Carter, we mentioned it on both Pelican Sports Radio and here on Tiger's Roar. The men's basketball team really stumbled down the stretch. These were winnable games, and you know, they got thumped by Ole Miss, thumped by Auburn, let one get away against Tennessee. They finish up conference play with a record of 7-9, which is an improvement over last year. They only won three games a year before. 17-13 overall. Signature win, if you will, against Marquette back in December. But they got their work cut out. We just heard from Brian Lazar at TigerBait.com. There's no guarantees that they're even in the NIT tournament now.
Yeah, and it's tough for LSU to stumble down the stretch like they did. Offensively, they just got away from what working. And that was Justin Hamilton down low. And Justin really could never get in a rhythm. And most of those games against Tennessee, it was a little bit better. And you saw it was a little bit closer of a game, partially also because LSU was at home in this game. Tomorrow, they play the Arkansas Razorbacks at noon. I like LSU's matchup against that one. Arkansas does not travel well outside of Bud Walton Arena. I think Mickelson and Sanchez down low could cause some problems for LSU. But I think Justin Hamilton's a better player than both those guys. The matchup is B.J. Young versus Anthony Hickey. Both those true freshmen are both all SEC freshmen this year. And we'll see. Whoever wins that matchup, I think, wins the game. I like Anthony Hickey in that matchup, and I like the Tigers to win.
Well, and then Carter Bryant will be in New Orleans for the SEC tournament tomorrow. I'll take care of Pelican Sports Radio, but he will do his best to call in with an update for us to recap the LSU game, get player and coach's comments, whether they win or lose, as well as he could update us on the game that'll be going on. There'll be one underway when we're on the air with Pelican Sports Radio. Now, they did have a question and answer segment, a pre-tournament press conference with LSU basketball coach Trent Johnson, and we have that for you now here that you can take a look. Again, they play Arkansas at 12 noon in the New Orleans Arena tomorrow on Thursday. If they win, they play Kentucky at 12 noon on Friday. If they lose, it's put the sneakers back in the box and get ready for hopefully NIT. But if they lose tomorrow, as Brian Lazar pointed out, the chances will be very, very slim. Not saying it won't happen, but they'll need a little luck on their side. So here's the comments from Coach Trent Johnson, question and answer about the SEC tournament.
Coach, I know you played Arkansas just a couple weeks ago, a game that you guys had in control for the most part, end of the game, and got to a two-point game. What made it difficult for your team against them down the stretch? Was it their defense? Was it but they were banging on you inside in the paint? What was it?
Well, their pressure causes problems for you because they attack you offensively, but they give you so many different looks on the defensive end, whether it's the 2-2-1 on the full court, man-to-man, run and jump, 3-2, face guard, go back to a matchup zone. So they really do a good job of keeping you out of rhythm, but they're always in the attack mode defensively, and then they're always in the attack mode offensively. So their game, regardless who they play, is going to play in spurts. So it puts a premium on if you don't get back and limit their transition opportunities, keep them out the middle on the half court, you're going to struggle. For us, we have to, like any team we've had success against this year, we've got to get this thing where we go inside out, pound the ball in the post, and shoot the ball well.
Do you have a hand up, Bob? Go ahead.
Hey, Coach, how you doing?
I'm good.
Mardricus Wade, I guess he's leading the conference in three-point shooting, just under 48%. He's a guy that shot 20% last year in like 44 attempts. What's your take on a guy, you know, what's he done this year and to improve that much?
Well, he's a big improvement, but, you know, whether it's him, whether it's BJ, whether it's Scott, you know, there are four of them that shoot the three, but also they put it on the floor well. So, yeah, you push them off the three-point line, then they can bounce it, one or two, three dribbles, get in the lane. But he is – I want to say him and Steele from Mississippi State. Every time I watch tape on those two, it seems like they don't miss. They seem like they never miss two perimeter jump shots in a row. But this team in Arkansas, they've got three, four perimeter guys that shoot the three, but also they can really put it on the floor and get to the rim. So it puts a lot of pressure on your defense. It put a lot of pressure on your post guys being to help.
Okay, I think in the back there was next. Go ahead.
Thank you. Coach, can you talk about how much progress you think the program has made this year? And do you think you have to win a game in this tournament to clinch some kind of postseason opportunity?
Well, the second question, I don't know. And I don't spend a lot of time worrying about that as opposed to just making sure we play good basketball and play better basketball, excuse me, than what we played in the last two weeks. And a lot of that's been the reciprocal of us not defending, as the kids said, but also the ball not going down for us. Now, in terms of the progress of the program, well, you look at the numbers. Yeah, we've improved in win-loss cases. But for me, I tend to evaluate that at the end of the year because bottom line is there are more games to be played right now. And if you would have asked me that question 2 weeks ago, my answer would have been the same, but everybody else would have probably thought we were on cloud nine because we were, you know, in a pretty good situation. So I tend to wait to the end of the year and evaluate everything starting with me going down.
As we mentioned, LSU plays Arkansas at noon in the New Orleans Arena tomorrow. They split the season series with Arkansas, with each team winning on their home floor. Arkansas won up in Fayetteville, I want to say by 9 points. LSU flipped that around one, I think won by 6 points in Baton Rouge. I was at that LSU-Arkansas game in Baton Rouge. I think Arkansas has got the potential to be a good team. They just struggled on the road this year, just like most SEC teams did. Going to be a tough task. Let's get some comments from the players talking about the Southeastern Conference tournament. Then we'll come back and get Carter's take on the game against Arkansas tomorrow.
Up questions for either of the student athletes. We'll start right here in the front. Bob, go ahead.
This is for both guys. Yeah, like Coach said, it obviously has been a tough couple weeks. Just kind of talk about the team's attitude coming into the tournament, how you guys are feeling.
Anthony, you want to take that first?
We're feeling pretty confident. You know, everybody getting that confidence back. Everybody pumped up. We're more hungry for the wins. We got a big making up to do, and we're going to own up to what we need to do as a team.
Same for Justin.
We're really excited for this new opportunity, and we've been working really hard the past couple days in practice and just getting back to what we were doing in the beginning of the year, or the middle of the SEC play, and we're just ready to show everyone what we can do.
Okay, hands up. Other questions? Go on the right side. Go ahead.
Justin, could you talk about the benefit of playing this tournament so close to Baton Rouge, having to only travel 80 miles and you feel like maybe you guys can get a boost from the home crowd here?
It's great. We didn't have to take a flight, and so that was always good. We just drove down here today, and so we're hoping that we can have as much people come here, and we're going to have the home crowd like we do in the PMAC.
Okay, do you have one? Yeah, go ahead right in the front here. Right, no, over here. Right there, right, see the hand? There you go.
For both players, can you talk a little bit about the last three games? Was there any common thread and why y'all struggled so much? I don't know, just what y'all were thinking those last three
Anthony.
Games.
Last two games, you know, late situations on in the game. Our defense, you know, we slacked on the defensive end. We didn't execute on the offensive end. It was our own fault as a team. And good, it was in the early on in the year. And we got another opportunity, and we're going to take owner of it.
Justin.
We slacked off in the defensive end at times. We didn't execute, and we know that it was all on us, and we know that we can fix those things. And so in the past 3 days, we've been trying to get back to playing LSU basketball and just executing and playing with a lot of effort and intensity.
Question in the back.
All three guys, I guess, could start with Trent. Coach, is this a type of tournament where, you know, a lower seed can do well, catch lightning in a bottle? You saw Georgia do it in 2008 and win the tournament, being the lowest seed.
Let me, we're doing players first, but go ahead and answer that, and then we'll take the two players. Go ahead and do that one.
Well, I think when you look at the balance of this league, and it speaks volumes to South Carolina, early in the year going on the road to Ohio State, one of the premier teams in the country, and having a chance to beat them there. You know, obviously Kentucky has went wire to wire, but when you look at the balance of this league, I think if any team is not ready to play and play to their strengths, certainly certain teams can advance in this tournament. So, you know, a lot happens at this time of year. You know, a lot of guys are banged up. But again, the bottom line is you do what you've been successful at all year long and you'll have an opportunity, especially with the balance in this league this year.
That's the same for Anthony?
Like Coach said, it's about who finishes it all at the end of the season. You got another opportunity. You play everybody again, you get another opportunity, and you're just able to complete what you're going to do.
And Justin?
Yeah, it's March, so anything can happen. And so we know that coming into this, no matter what seed you are, you still have to play your best game to beat the opponent.
Okay, other questions for either student athletes? Let's come back to the front.
This for both guys. Just what's your take on Arkansas after playing twice and splitting home and home?
Anthony?
Best team gonna win, you know, it's either win or go home. We already played, we know we're gonna do, but we just still gotta adjust to what they're gonna do. We gotta limit our turnovers and be ready on the defensive end for their offensive pressure. So it's gonna be a great defensive game on both ends.
And Justin?
Yeah, Arkansas is a really talented team. They're a young team. They pressure a lot, and so we just have to handle the ball and just make sure that we execute our stuff and don't get into a hurry, fast-paced game that they want.
We continue with Tigers Roar. All SEC teams, as voted on by the coaches in the Southeastern Conference, were announced. A couple of LSU players recognized. First off, Justin Hamilton, the junior transfer from Iowa State. Second team, all SEC. Had he finished a little stronger, could have been first team, but nonetheless, 13 points, 7 rebounds a game, free throws, decent percentage. Justin Hamilton played well. He improved a lot during the year, but he, like the whole team, kind of struggled down the stretch.
And a lot of people go to Justin's offensive game. This year, overall, defensively, he became a better player. Watching him a couple times in practice and in a scrimmage that Coach Johnson let me in, his defensive foot speed wasn't that great. That improved throughout the year, and overall, he's been the best player on this team.
And also, freshman Anthony Hickey was named to the All-Southeastern Conference freshman team, 9 points a game, 60 steals. Decent 3-point percentage, free throws, probably wants to work on that, be a little better at that next year. But he's a point guard. He ran the show. He ran the floor. And like he told you for an interview here on Pelican Sports TV prior to the season started, he wants this to be his team. And he took many steps in that direction. And I expect him to be even more of a leader next year.
And you don't see that from a freshman. You just don't. And after a loss earlier this year, he said, I can't take losing. I want to get this team winning again. And he led LSU on that long winning streak in the middle of the year. Of course, this young team struggled down the stretch. We'll see the future of this program under Anthony Hickey get better as the seasons go along.
When we come back, we've been telling you about Mo Isom. Carter did a special feature with her last fall. We're going to show you that. It's really cool. It's going to give you a good look and a good feel for who she is, from homecoming queen to outstanding goalkeeper. She was a senior on Brian Lee's soccer team. She had to try out with LSU football. That was a national story. Saw it all over the national sports shows, all over the internet, everywhere. We're going to show you that feature, and Carter is a good friend of Mo Isom's. We're going to have plenty to tell you about her. All of that's up when we return with more Tigers Roar here on Pelican Sports TV, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and New Orleans, and on the internet at pelicansportstv.com.
I'm Bruce Mitchell, and you're watching Pelican Sports TV.
When you need to hire, you need to know about BetterBatonRougeJobs.com, BetterAcadianaJobs.com, and NewOrleansJobsList.com. We have a faster, more affordable way to find and hire employees. Now you can save even more with this special offer from Pelican Sports TV. Post your jobs on any of these sites and use the promo code PELICANSPORTS to save an additional $25. Find qualified applicants and save money, too, with promo code PELICANSPORTS. And remember, we're free for job seekers and great for Louisiana business.
For the thirsty, for those who hang out in packs, for heroes, for sidekicks, for those who see the glass half empty, for those who see it half full, for those on the right, for those on the left, for those with nicknames, for those with curves, for people that cycle, for people that recycle, for BFFs, for frenemies, for those with style, for lovers, for families, for big families, for everyone.
What did you do this week? That's just some of the fun things we do every week here at Space Camp. Get more information about our programs at spacecamp.com. I want you to come join our team.
Attention all companies dealing with cash flow problems. Companies are going out of business every day. Bankruptcies are at an all-time high. Accounts receivable delinquencies are at the highest levels in decades. Let us help your business collect money owed to your business. NRH and Associates has the solutions. Let NRH and Associates utilize their innovative collection methods to get cash flow back into your business. Call 601-889-0501. That number again, 601-889-0501.
We continue with Tigers Roar. We told you about it. Mo Isom has gotten publicity nationwide, tons of publicity here in Baton Rouge for her outstanding effort on the soccer team. She's on the cover of 225 magazine, Homecoming Queen. And we're going to do for you right now, this was taped last fall, a challenge with Carter Bryant and Mo Isom on goalkeeping and stopping the scores. It'll give you a really good look at Carter's lack of athletic ability and Mo Isom's skills and what a great person she is. And Carter will come back and tell you a whole lot more about her. Enjoy this feature from the fall here on Pelican Sports TV, senior goalkeeper Mo Isom and Carter Bryant.
Well, also we have a very special chance right now, the one that we've been all waiting for. As you know, Pelican Sports fans, I've been doing a bunch of different challenges. I've been up against Walter Henning of the track team in a hammer throw competition and Julian Gauthier of the LSU tennis team. And of course, both of those times I lost miserably.
That's going to be a third time again now.
You see, what Mo doesn't understand is I was an all-conference soccer performer.
Really?
Back in my high school heyday. And before all this gray hair showed up, I was a dominant performer on the pitch, the full 120 yards.
Okay.
So right now we're going to challenge each other to a penalty kick shootout. And the one thing you don't understand is I come out here prepared, ready to go.
Oh, see, I thought the dress pants, I was looking forward to ruining the dress pants.
I'm prepared, ready to go, ready to whoop some tiger butt right now.
Oh, man.
See, the thing is that you might have a tiger's really type of confidence, but you don't have the courage of the lion, the strength of a seagull.
Tigers always trump lions. What are you trying to do right now? I was hoping to ruin your dress pants, not only having you dive around, I was going to make you urinate yourself at least once.
Wow.
So.
Okay, well, let's see how this turns
out. We'll see.
Of course, we're going to win this game. Let's go.
Lions, get real. Prepare so hard to lose. It's unreal. What are you, next Karate Kid? Let's go. Ready, boy? Break his wrist with this ball. It's gonna be bad. So many times
it happens too fast. You take she's taking the glove off.
Where would you like me to place it?
It doesn't matter. I'm not,
you can literally tell me where to hit it and I'll still score on you.
You can go right there.
Okay. Ready? Down the middle so I can make you look foolish. You know what I mean?
So lucky. It's not even, I can't even put into words how lucky that is.
See, I have to let him put a couple in just to get his confidence up. It's like a man thing. You're probably gonna shoot it over the top this time.
Really?
Yeah. Made me get dirty.
This isn't easy, baby. This is not gonna be easy. The real challenge.
Your wrist hurt more or your pride?
Wrist.
Okay.
God.
I guess right. Really too much power. My name's a power, so that's, we're in a dilemma here. But, I mean, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do about that. You too.
Woo! Ready when you are.
I went for the chip. I thought she was gonna
die. Missed, Mike.
I tried to be cheeky.
So this does it. If I score, I win.
Yeah, it's over after that.
Oh, man.
You see, that's the thing. I just wanted to put the pressure on her.
Here's the thing. You want to raise the stakes? You want me to go blindfolded or anything like that?
I mean, you can if you want. Yeah, close your eyes and do it.
You want me to close my eyes?
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Make sure you stay on those eyes.
Hold on, I got to step it off then.
All right. You see, of course, we have to handicap performance because I'm a college student and she's a college athlete. If she makes this, I'm really impressed. I'm not gonna lie.
You ready?
Yeah.
This is eyes closed.
Eyes closed.
No!
She fob-holed me.
How does it feel?
Oh, it feels great. You know, not every day you get beat up by a girl. Pelican Sports, we would like to thank Mo Isom. We all know about your blog, so I've gotten more action with her than all of you out there. So.
That is an absolute lie.
Well, yeah, of course, action right here. You know,
okay.
You see, now she's the one thinking like that. But anyway.
My mind was in the gutter.
Good luck for the rest of the year.
Thank
she beat
you.
Me 3-2. I thought this was a challenge I can actually win. I got a little confident. I thought she was going to dive up the middle. Just a little cheeky chip, but
mm-mm.
I took
mm-mm.
you for granted. You know.
You did.
I feel like I just left Shady's at 2 a.m. That's how much I'm hurting right
you
now.
You just got beat up.
I just got the crap knocked out.
You know what I mean?
But anyway, thank you, Mo. Always come out and support them. I'll be out here a lot this year. Hopefully we can catch up with you later. Maybe after this year I can go and get ready for our next penalty kick shootout because mm-hmm. we are going to do this again.
It's all about off-season training. So if I were you, I'd start now and I'd just grind. Just rise and grind.
See,
you know what I mean?
My seagull strength wasn't here with me today.
Right.
That was a big thing.
Right.
But anyway, big thanks to Brian Lee and Will Staff for letting us come out here today. Mo, thank you so much.
You are welcome.
All right. Thank you very much, Pelican Sports. This has been another power challenge that came up just short yet again. For the rest of the year, hopefully I can try something else. I'm a great high diver, by the way. Anyway, this is Carter Bryant reporting live from the LSU soccer field. See you later. I hate you, you know that, right?
It's okay. You tried.
Carter Bryant, tell everybody else a little bit more about Mo Isom.
Well, as you can tell, she's a fantastic personality, and we're actually in the same Bible study, FCA Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and she's a phenomenal. She's a great leader, great personality, and as everyone knows right now, she's trying out for the LSU football team, and she had a tryout earlier this week on Tuesday. I spoke to her about the tryout the other day, and things went a little rough for her. The wind was blowing a lot, and that wasn't really a clean tryout. Coach Miles said that in the post-game, the post-practice presser, and we'll see where Mo goes from there. All I have to say to everybody is that if there's anybody out there that can overcome the odds with Mo's unbelievable history, or unbelievable story to where she is right now, I think it's Mo Isom, and if anybody's going to break a trend, break this the no women in football. There have been women that have played Division I football. To get that going at a big SEC school such as LSU, if there was one person to do it, it'd be Mo.
All right. Well, we wish her the best of luck, and we appreciate all the cooperation she's given us here at Pelican. When we come back, we'll take our weekly run through the LSU athletic department with Carter Bryant. I'm Tommy Chrysler, and stay with us. This is Tigers Roar.
I'm Elizabeth Tynan, Miss Louisiana Team USA 2011.
And I'm Paige Pennock, Miss Louisiana USA 2011.
And you're watching Pelican Sports TV.
Hey, hey, where you can expect to find the best pre-owned? Right here at North American Auto on Airline in Gonzales. Folks, every car comes with a warranty. Cars, trucks, SUVs, You name it, we got it. Get pre-approved. BRCarCredit.com. Folks, don't you leave till you see me.
One of the key attributes that really puts Papa John's pizza over the top is our meats. Nobody does what Papa John's does.
For just $11, get our new double-layered premium pepperoni pizza, loaded with a layer of our signature pepperoni, plus a layer of oversized deli-style pepperoni. Just $11 for a large. Plus, get double points all weekend long and earn free pizza fast with Papa Rewards, only at PapaJohns.com. Sign up now.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
I'm attorney Kerry Bryson. An IRS problem is a serious legal matter. The IRS has thousands of agents trained to understand it all. So don't trust an out-of-town salesperson. Come meet with us in person at our office right here in Baton Rouge. Your first visit will be free and confidential. If you're a Louisiana resident and have an IRS problem, hire a Louisiana attorney. Hire me, Kerry Bryson.
When you need to hire, you need to know about BetterBatonRougeJobs.com, BetterAcadianaJobs.com, and NewOrleansJobsList.com. We have a faster, more affordable way to find and hire employees. Now you can save even more with this special offer from Pelican Sports TV. Post your jobs on any of these sites and use the promo code PELICANSPORTS to save an additional $25. Find qualified applicants and save money, too, with promo code PELICANSPORTS. And remember, we're free for job seekers and great for Louisiana business.
Hey, hey, you expecting a refund and want a new car? Come to North American Automotive Group on Airline. We make it easy. Bring your W-2, file your taxes, use it towards your down payment, and drive home today. North American Auto on Airline.
It is time for our weekly run through the LSU Athletic Department. We do it each and every week here on Tigers Roar TV and take a look at some of the other things happening in the Athletic Department. And we'll start off with baseball. Coach Palmieri's team ranked now 11-2 overall, defeated Tulane in New Orleans 5-0 on Tuesday night in front of a big crowd at Turchin Stadium. What a game by Aaron Nola. Went 8 innings, only threw 78 pitches, 62 of them for strikes, scattered 3 hits. Got a nice defensive play from Jacoby Jones, but what a job by freshman Aaron Nola. Tulane coach Rick Jones commenting that he never saw a freshman come into his stadium and have a performance like that. Just had to tip your hat to Nola. You see some heat on the outside corner right there against Tulane, one of their leading hitters, Schaefer. I mean, that's as good a pitch as you're going to get. And then take a look at this changeup. The best pitch in baseball is a changeup, and there's one right there. So Aaron Nola with a great job. They had swept Dartmouth last weekend out of the Ivy League in Alec Box Stadium. And this coming week, they got an odd series, Carter, a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday thing. Two games with Michigan Friday and Saturday, two games with Notre Dame Sunday and Monday. Notre Dame and Michigan will play during the day on the weekend, and that's free admission for you big-time baseball fans and nuts. You can get out there and watch that. So LSU baseball, despite the back-to-back losses to Appalachian State a couple weekends ago, they're winning some games, doing what they got to do.
Yeah, they're taking care of business against teams that they're better than. And what do we say on Pelican Sports Radio? If Aaron Nola, the deeper he can go into the game, the more arms you can save for this weird four-game series. And usually with the amount of rest from a Tuesday game to a weekend series is enough for a baseball pitcher to get ready. But this does allow Palmieri to have a wide-open plethora of pitchers to go through in a four-game series. I can't wait to see how it goes about, which arms pitch, what kind of innings this weekend.
And you see Nate Mason catch right there, catching the ground ball. Watch this. In the previous replay, Mason Katz, and what a week he had for the LSU Tigers. Such a week. Mason Katz from Jesuit High School down in New Orleans. You see him right there completing the double play and running off the field. There's Mason Katz. He was named the National Player of the Week. Wait till you see the numbers that he put up. 13 for 19 with 3 home runs, 12 runs, slugging percentage through the roof, on-base percentage. Actually reached base 17 consecutive plate appearances, one shy of an NCAA record. Incredible week, led the Tigers to a 5-0 mark. Mason Katz was expected to be one of the key players for LSU this year. He's wearing number 8 from Mikey Matuk, and he is so. And this week, he filled Mikey's shoes for sure. A tip of the hat to Mason Katz, the National Player of the Week.
And one stat that always stands out is OPS, on base plus slugging. And you saw he's well over 2,000 after his unbelievable tear. That's as good of a week you could possibly have in an LSU baseball uniform. One of the best offensive explosions. I know he wasn't facing the best pitching, but when this lineup needed him the most, he has stepped up after that tough Appalachian series. And if your guy in the middle of the lineup's hitting well, everyone else is also going to be seeing good pitches as well. And you feed off that confidence. And you saw guys like Austin Nola hit the baseball well, Jacoby Jones, Rafe Rimes. You're seeing this lineup really starting to gel together. And if they can start hitting the baseball, that was a big thing before the year. They don't have enough hitting. They're answering that call right now with their offensive tear they're on.
So, again, LSU's got Michigan and Notre Dame coming to the box. A four-game weekend full of baseball, free admission during the day when Michigan plays Notre Dame. LSU playing Friday night against Michigan, so do check that out. Kick it over to the Lady Tiger softball team. First-year coach Beth Tarina. Tonight, down on the bayou in Thibodaux, a game completed within the last hour. They have defeated Nicholls State in a five-run mercy rule game, 10-2. There's an eight-run mercy rule in softball. Lady Tigers now 11-7. I'm telling you, that game ended an hour ago. Struggled a little bit up in Oklahoma, but it was all ranked teams that they played. They have the Purple and Gold Challenge coming up at Tiger Park this weekend with Mississippi Valley State and the Troy Trojans from over in Alabama coming to town. Nice win down on the bayou in Thibodaux against Nicholls State tonight.
You look at LSU softball, and this is one thing I've been saying every week, and I think it's going to hold true, is that Beth Tarina, she is beating the teams that her team is supposed to beat and losing against the top competition. And early in the year, when you play a bunch of tough competition, I always compare this team to the Michigan State Spartans in basketball because they're playing such a tough schedule early on. And once you get seasoned, later on in the year, you're ready for these pressure games. You're ready to play the top opponents in college softball. So you look at what LSU, I like their pace they're going on right now, 11-7, a little bit of a misleading record because of the tough teams they play.
Brittany Mack, senior pitcher for the Lady Tigers, was selected in the National Professional Fast Pitch Softball League College Senior Draft. 40 career victories, as you see. She's been named SEC Player of the Week on three different occasions. Brittany Mack, selected first in the College Senior Draft.
I love Brittany Mack, and she was my favorite Tiger to interview last year when Chris and I went out there. And unbelievable personality, dynamite on the mound, and she definitely needs to pick it up. And at the beginning of the year, she was a little bit shaky, blew a lead against Penn State, but look at her now. Her and Rochelle Fico, one of the best 1-2 combinations in all of college softball. If they can keep it up, they lose some when they in their lineup. They don't have a powerful lineup. But with those two on top of your pitching staff, you definitely have a chance in every softball game you play.
Tip of the hat to a couple of Louisiana guys nominated for the College Basketball Hall of Fame, three-time All-SEC performer at LSU, Joe Dean, and then Willis Reed, a great Joe Dean. You see All-SEC 50-52, first player selected by the NBA draft. He was an LSU athletic director for 14 years. He's been elected to the National College Basketball Hall of Fame. And then also Willis Reed played at Grambling State, won three conference titles, three times to the postseason. Great NBA career, as you know, by Willis Reed. You get a picture in his New York Knickerbocker uniform. There he is against Bill Russell. But Willis Reed, who grew up in North Louisiana and had a great career at Grambling, tip of the hat to those guys for going into the College Basketball Hall of Fame and representing the state of Louisiana. Willis Reed representing Grambling State University and Joe Dean, LSU. Special award in men's golf, John Peterson, NCAA champ for LSU, was named the Tiger Athletic Foundation Male Athlete of the Year. Of course, what he did for the LSU golf team was incredible. He's now out on the PGA Tour. So tip of the hat to John being named the Tiger Athletic Foundation Athlete of the Year, National Individual Champion in the NCAA, three-time All-American honors during his career at LSU. Women's golf, Coach Karen Bonson's team has moved up to number 5 in the NCAA rankings. You see the Tigers in there at number 5 in the first spring poll. Karen Bonson, a longtime golf coach of the women's golf team out there at LSU, doing a great job. Also, LSU track and field in the final NCAA power ratings. You look at the men first, they're number 4. Little SEC flavor up top, especially with A&M coming into the conference on July 1. So the final ranking, and then the women, number 3. Again, some more SEC flavor. They always see your home state, Arkansas, in them track and field polls. So a tip of hat to those two track teams of men and women at LSU. Once again, doing a great job. When we come back, it'll be time for the final segment of Tigers Roar. We'll recap a few things, tell you about Pelican Sports Radio, and a whole lot more. Carter Bryant, Tommy Chrisam, Pelican Sports TV, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, New Orleans. Stay with us.
Mo Isom of the LSU women's soccer team, and you're watching Pelican Sports TV.
Hello, my name is Debbie. Welcome to Debbie's Bridal, a formal affair.
Come see the many great lines we carry in bridal. Bridesmaids, mothers, flower girls, tuxes, and more. We also carry over 25 top designer lines in debutante gowns, Mardi Gras, pageant, and prom. Come meet me and my staff with over 30 years of bridal and pageant experience. Debbie's Bridal, a formal affair, Burnside and Gonzales, where service matters.
40 years, four decades, nearly half a century. That's how long the citizens of Greater Baton Rouge have chosen Richards Honda. A simple, sincere, and honest process.
Louisiana's oldest and most experienced Honda dealership for over 40 years, Richards Honda.
What did you do this week? That's just some of the fun things we do every week here at Space Camp. Get more information about our programs at spacecamp.com. I want you to come join our team.
Now is a great time to lock into buying a new home. Come by our decorated model home in Greystone of Prairieville. We are starting the development of our second filing and offering builder's special closeout pricing on the remaining homes in our first filing. No money down, and builders pay closing costs. For more information, visit our website at greystoneofprairieville.com. Come home to Greystone.
40 years, four decades, nearly half a century. That's how long the citizens of Greater Baton Rouge have chosen Richards Honda. A simple, sincere, and honest process.
Louisiana's oldest and most experienced Honda dealership for over 40 years, Richards Honda.
We continue with Tigers Roar, putting the wrap on this week's edition. We remind you we're year-round live on a Wednesday night from 8 to 10 p.m. If you're catching us Thursday, Friday, or Saturday, you got a replay going, and we appreciate you taking time to watch Tigers Roar, and we ask you to spread the roar about our program. It's a weekly look at LSU athletics, and like we did tonight, we mix in a little New Orleans Saints, a little Peyton Manning for you, and we try to get you the very best. Our staff here at Pelican Sports TV, Chris and Nick and Michael and Alan and Marty, they do a great job putting this thing together for you each and every week. And we appreciate you watching. I know they appreciate it as well. Once again, Carter, LSU spring football will be back on the field tomorrow, Thursday. Again, the spring game is Saturday, March 31st in Tiger Stadium at 12:30. Prior to that game, or right around 12:30, they will have a ceremony celebrating the SEC championship from last year. You get a little look at some footage here. And Carter, we've talked about it a few times tonight, but it's good to have something else to talk about other than the January 9th game against Alabama.
And there's a lot of positions up for grabs. I mean, you think that Markevis Mingo and Sam Montgomery at defensive end just have the starting positions locked up. You have a young guy, Jamari Roscoe, number 59, a guy that really played well toward the back end of the season and played a lot of special teams. He's a guy I like a lot, and if you look at his drill, I saw him in a Big Cat the other day on some different footage. He brings his hands. He's violent. I can't wait to see how this position battle goes up front at defensive tackle and at defensive end.
You get a look at some of the footage from practice. Our staff was out there on yesterday, and that was the first time in full pads, and that's always adds a little bit more excitement to what's going on.
You saw Ronald Martin versus James Wright right there, really physical. Tommy, I like to take you up on a Big Cat drill. You see right here, Craig.
You want me on a Big Cat drill?
Oh, man, I light you up real quick. This is Craig Lawson and Jared Fobbs going at it right now. Both guys fighting for playing spots. Both guys underperformed last season. They expected to see him on the field. And this is also another great matchup. Woo! That's how you put someone on the ground.
Jalen Collins. Look, got his teammates' respect there.
There you go. And that's how you play as a defensive player. You get in someone, you get your hands inside, and you put them on their butt, and that's how you put them in their place. And right here, this is Jarvis Landry right here, a really physical wide receiver. Got his hands inside, going up against, I can't see the number there, but that was a great matchup against those two right there. The Big Cat drill, better bring your hat. And it's unbelievable. I love watching that drone. I love to get my chance.
And it's kind of all eyes on everybody. You got two guys there, offense guy, defense guy, and everybody else is in a big circle around them looking at it, coaches and the whistles. And it's not something they do every day. They don't do it a whole lot during the fall either, but it's something that happens in spring practice, and it excites the team, to say the least.
And the happiest people during that drill, the green shirts, the guys,
they don't have to do it.
The quarterback smiling from ear to ear. Hey, you guys, y'all have all the fun. I don't want to go in there and get hit. So I like that. You see Zach and Randall and Steven Rivers over there with big-time smiles. You got to love that.
Yeah, they don't put quarterbacks in that drill, if they didn't have a green shirt.
But Zach's a competitor. I think he'd go in there and lay some hats.
They're not going to let him do that.
Quarterback?
I don't think I'm not saying they will.
I'm not that stupid. But if he did go in there, he's a big physical guy and big hands. I'd love to see him go in there.
Once again, Carter, you're going to be in New Orleans tomorrow at the SEC basketball tournament. LSU plays Arkansas at 12 noon in the New Orleans Arena. I'll be handling Pelican Sports Radio from 3 to 4 on KKAY 1590 AM. You'll call in with a report if you can get freed up out of the press room on that game, which will be over by the time Pelican Sports Radio hits. So I know you're looking forward to being down in New Orleans and checking out some SEC basketball.
I can't wait. Weekend is shaping up pretty well. My dad, who's here tonight, Dr. Brian School, we're going to be going down there and watching some great SEC basketball. And I can't wait to see how LSU goes up against Arkansas. This is a rubber match, a battle of the boot. I know it's not as big as it is in football as it is in basketball. I mean, it's not as big in basketball as it is in football, but I can't wait to see how Anthony Hickey steps up against the great young guards for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Andre Stringer, Ralston Turner, they have to play a little bit better, shoot the ball a little bit more efficiently. If they do that, LSU basketball should win the game rather easily.
Well, and another thing you got to remember, if you're a big college hoops fan, the Final Four will be in New Orleans this year. So the Final Four, I want to say March 31st, same day as the LSU spring football game, will be the semifinals that Saturday. And then, of course, that Monday night, April 2, they'll crown an NC2A champ. Final Four has been in New Orleans before, and the city will do a great job hosting again this year.
I can't wait to see who's going to be around there. Syracuse, Kansas, Missouri, Michigan State, Ohio State, North Carolina, Duke. They're all going to be around there. Let's see how things turn out. I like the Michigan State Spartans right now to win it all.
We do want to remind you about Pelican Sports Radio. Please spread the word about our program. It's on KKAY 1590 AM on your radio dial. KKAY1590.com on the internet, or Global Radio KKAY.com on the internet. There's a free app for the smartphones at TuneIn, TuneIn.com. You can check it out. Monday through Friday from 3 to 4 o'clock, we take phone calls, we take emails. Tomorrow, we're going to give away some tickets to the Monster Jam Truck Show at the Baton Rouge River Center Arena this weekend. Give away tickets to Easton Corbin Country Music Friday night at the Texas Club in Baton Rouge. Plenty of ticket giveaways tomorrow, so be tuned in. We'll tell you how you can enter those drawings and have a chance to win those tickets. That's tomorrow on the program. We'll also speak to Ruffin Rodrigue from Ruffino's Restaurant, as well as Ken Trahan of SportsNola.com. That'll all come your way on tomorrow's edition of Pelican Sports Radio. But it is there Monday through Friday from 3 to 4 p.m., part of the all-day lineup with Jordy Hultberg in the morning from 7 to 9, Chad Bluen from 9 to 11, Buddy Sanji from 1 to 3, and, of course, Pelican Sports Radio from 3 until 4. Great way to keep up with it all is find us on Facebook. The Facebook page is Pelican Broadcasting. Twitter account is at Pelican Sports. We have the YouTube page. And as always, we welcome your emails at pelicanbroadcasting@gmail.com. Any question, comment, or topic you may have, the email address is pelicanbroadcasting@gmail.com. I want to thank Stevie Blaze of Lillian Axe for coming on the show with us tonight. We showed you the caged-in video. We'll show it again next week. You want to spread the word about that, but go get their new CD, the 11th effort by Lillian Axe. It's called The Days Before Tomorrow. It's online. It's in all the record stops. Lillian Axe, we want you to go get that CD, The Days Before Tomorrow. Also, the great stuff with Mo Isom, Brian Lazar of TigerBait.com. We appreciate all that here on the program. For Carter Bryant, I'm Tommy Kreisner. We'll talk to you on Pelican Sports Radio tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in to Tigers Roar, and spread the roar.